You know, if I hadn't taken over Paige's room, this never would have happened. This is all my fault.
Well, what's done is done.
Okay, you two really need to get a room.
Yeah.
Hear these words, hear my cry, spirit from the other side. Come to thee, I summon thee, cross now the great divide.
Well, it's about time you called to say hello.
Oh, Arma, darlings.
We got a problem.
Well, you're not the only one.
Or about. No, magic makes it grow. Summoning her spirit already gave it power.
Oh, you must be Chris, the new white lighter. You know, he doesn't look very qualified for the job.
Chris, just let me blast it.
She's right, Orb. Oh, for heaven's sakes, listen to them. We'll find a way to vanquish the foul thing later.
Now!
Oh. You and Paige moved out? When?
A few weeks ago. But we're handling everything.
Dear, you have Paige stuck in the past and a demonic blob roaming the manor. Exactly how are you handling things?
We're still in an adjustment period.
There would be no adjustment period if you were living under one roof. Why in heaven's name did you move out?
To be with Jason. You said it yourself, never give up on love, remember?
I didn't say give up on your sisters. And you, you're the oldest. How could you let them move out?
You know, it really wasn't that hard, because they deserve a shot at a normal life.
They're not normal, Piper. And neither are you. When are you going to learn that?
Well, I guess never.
All this over men. How many times have I told you men are utensils? You use them, wash them, and throw them in a drawer until you need them again.
Shh. Everyone quiet. I can hear it. I think it's in the wall. Yep. It's in the wall. Okay, we're gonna need Paige. It took the power of three to vanquish this thing in the future.
What? If you knew that, why didn't you tell me that in the first place?
Because I could barely get two of you together, let alone three. Besides, this thing's not that big right now, and I thought two could handle it.
Leo, you take point. Chris here is much too green to guide my girls.
What? You know what? You can just stop that
Quiet. It's time to give this floundering ship a rudder. Now, which boots did Paige put on?
Red go-go boots.
We've got a problem. Those boots took Paige back to the Summer of Love, which was one of the most crucial times of my life.
What do you mean, crucial?
Your grandfather, Alan, rest his soul, was a sweet man, but he led me straight down the hippy-dippy trail.
You were a flower child?
Yeah, well, don't rub it in. What's important is that Alan was killed by my best friend. I didn't know it then, but she was evil, and I walked in right after it happened.
What'd you do?
Well, let's just say that my peacenik days ended fast, along with that bitch, Robin. If she hadn't killed Alan,
you'd still be a flower child.
And the charmed ones would be dead. I know I'm a ball buster, but it kept me alive to protect my girls from all the demons that came after them as kids. I cast my return to owner spell on a lot of clothes that summer. So
we get to go back there? And we get to meet our grandfather?
Don't make too much out of it, because whatever you do, you can't change the past or tell anyone you're from the future.
Well, why does he get to?
Because I know what I'm doing.
Not from where I'm standing. I'll stay here with Leo and the newbie to contain the slime until you can bring Paige back to vanquish it, okay? Okay, girls, get dressed. You are going to the Summer of Love.